Now, you're doing a little bit of work for Mr. McCloskey, but I have to say, this is what popped to me the first time I saw him speak. You have an impression of the guy, right? You read what folks in the media have said. You read what, see the pictures. He's a very thoughtful guy. Kind of surprises you how thoughtful he is.
No, and I think, you know, one of the things that we've seen over time is that, you know, when he speaks to audiences, audiences are surprised. They're captivated. They find out that he's got some depth.
Yep.
He's not just a celebrity name only, you know, candidate. He's actually a thoughtful guy.
Tim Brinker, folks in Franklin County do a little bit of Republican primary voting, don't they?
They do. They certainly do.
You got, I guess, your constituent. I didn't know that until I interviewed you today. But you've got three other folks running. I know that Eric Greitens, however you want to look at it, there's a base of support in that party for him. Vicky Hartzler's got, you know, western part of the state. Eric Schmidt has done extremely well at garnering support. And McCloskey, where do you think that race is?
Well, in Franklin County, I can tell you it's going to be a real hot red race.
Yeah.
And where it is now, I couldn't put my thumb on it to be precise. But, you know, McCloskey's going to garner a lot of votes out of Franklin, especially as a result of the practicality. Now, the Attorney General is going to do the same thing, though. So it's going to be a real interesting race. You know, Eric Greitens is going to pull his, and those other folks are going to pull theirs, and it's going to be real fascinating to see who pulls through.
I was impressed. This was the same guy I saw speak in Poplar Bluff. There's a depth. The depth was probably a better word
right.
to the guy that I, you know, I got to say, it kind of took me by surprise. Scott Dieckhaus, though, I watched it Lincoln Days. I've watched at these events. Folks come up. It's bizarre. They want a selfie with him.
Everyone wants to take a picture.
As a guy that does campaigns for a living, what percent of those folks that want a selfie with the guy vote for him?
You know, it's tough to say, but I think that, you know, any time that you're drawn to someone or you're interested in someone, you're investing your time, even if it's 30 seconds just to take a selfie, that's an engagement, and that's the whole goal of campaigns is to engage voters.
I've seen things like that before. Folks like me with pictures of folks. I've not really seen it to that degree. I mean, there's a line of people in a selfie.
No,
Cole County, it was the most, they see all these guys.
So, you know, my business partner was kind of the first one to see it. You know, Mark McCloskey was a featured speaker at a Lincoln Days. They kind of went in not knowing what to expect. He was with one of our other clients, one of our other candidates, and they got there and they were both blown away. And they said it was just, you know, after he spoke, just people coming up, asking to take pictures, enthused, engaged, asking what they could do. And that was before he had announced.
Did you see when Rowden didn't show up 1 week for this week in Missouri politics, I got Ratliffon? All right, let me, Steve Butz, there's a name out there. I mean, Scott Sifton, somebody I know, probably the most effective Democrat state senator of the last 10 years. There's some other folks, Lucas Koontz raised some money. But there's a name that keeps coming back to me, and it's almost unfair to these other folks trying to get traction, but he's going to Clay County, the man who's got more people have walked into a booth and checked Jay Nixon than anybody, Thomas Hart Benton, Kit Bond, Symington's. Jay Nixon's got more votes than anyone. He's running. He's seriously thinking about running for this race, right?
I hope so. So I'm a big Scott Sifton fan.
Yep.
I'm on that bandwagon early, but I think a great candidate for our party would be Jay Nixon. Jay's proven he can win statewide, and he has that ability to bridge the rural-urban-suburban divide, and that's huge. So,
Terry, Jay Nixon gets in this race. Can he go to your district? Can he go to North City, to North County? And can he get Democrats on board, not just in the primary? Can he get them to turn out like they would for another candidate in the general?
I believe so, because he has a name in the community. So I believe that that would work. But, you know, we're all just hoping and praying that it's a Democrat.
I mean, look, Jay Nixon could go to Franklin County and get folks who that 10% that may vote Republican or Democrat, he can get 8 of that 10, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, there's you know, there's some practicality there, but I wouldn't go much further than that, quite frankly.
But well, you had that up around the state.
No, I think Jay Nixon, I was in the legislature when he was governor. I think Jay Nixon is the only hope that the Democrats have, and I think that door is only open if Eric Greitens wins the Republican primary.
Sure. Yeah.
I think Jay Nixon could beat Eric Greitens.